All right, we need to talk about 1.19, the wild update for Minecraft. Overall, I'm ecstatic for this update. During the 2019 biome vote, we had the option of voting mesa, swamp, or mountains. Mountains won, and that's how we ended up with the caves and cliffs update, but I personally voted for the swamp. I didn't even care about the boat chest or the frogs. I thought that mangrove trees would be a 10 out of 10 addition to the game. Every new wood means new trapdoors, new planks, fences, and more. New wood is just infinitely useful for building every time there is a new wood, and mangrove trees are just so cool and interesting. If you've ever played Donkey Kong Country Tropical Freeze in that level Mangrove Cove, you really appreciate how the roots and water interact. It's just beautiful, and how these big trees have cool canopies. Mangroves are one of the most aesthetic natural areas on Earth, in my opinion. They're really beautiful, and that's why I wanted Swamp to win. Basically, this update is the swamp update from the biome vote, and it's great too because not only is it the one that I originally wanted, but it shows that Mojang is keeping their promise of updating all of the biomes eventually. Before this, I kind of thought that they forgot about those old votes. I didn't really care for the frog during the initial vote, but Mojang went above and beyond with the frogs. The fact that they have the unique tadpole system and three variants and planned uses is just insane. I didn't expect that much focus on something like a tiny frog. They're shaping up to be really cool and interesting mobs, but also have that derpy vibe. I have a goat religion on the BobSMP, but who wants to run a frog religion with me in 1.19? I didn't put it in my features video, but yesterday I was discussing swamps and mangroves on Discord, and kind of predicted mud. Mud is just an overall great new addition to the game. I really like how it gives water bottles a new use, and how it can be used to create renewable clay. Like, clay has just always been hard to come by, and now that's more accessible, that's good. And mud bricks are phenomenal. The color is just so perfect for building, and the texture is something I'm a huge fan of. Yesterday in my video, I said I wanted dripstone bricks in 1.19, and I still think that they would be great, but if we never get them, then mud bricks are close enough to what I was envisioning and has the same usage for building in my eyes. The mangrove swamp biome is really cool looking, and I'm just overall happy that it's coming. This is a really great compliment to the world generation changes of 1.18. So even though it was delayed, I got what I wanted from the biome vote with the swamps. But before today, I never won a vote or got what I wanted. We didn't get the Isolager last year, didn't get the swamp the year before, and nor did Savannah win the really old biome vote for 1.14. But I finally voted today and got the results that I wanted. The LA mob won the vote, and I cannot be more excited. A lot of people are on that copium and trying to argue that it's not that useful, but I feel like anyone who's ever made an auto farm can see the utility in the LA, especially because of how it can be used as a wireless drone, pretty much. Copper golems would have indeed been cool for the steampunk aesthetic, but I personally like medieval and fantasy aesthetics more, so this cute little fairy will be cool, and who knows, my evil roleplaying on the server might become good with cute little minions such as this. And then we gotta talk about the deep dark. Like, I don't even know how to talk about it. It's just so interesting and cool. I was super bummed at first that it got delayed again, because like, what the hell? It was originally gonna be 1.17, and now it's 1.19, like 2 years after they originally proposed it. But it seems incredibly worth the wait based on how cool and interesting it is. They're adding abandoned ancient cities. It reminds me directly of Shilva Sanctum from Dark Souls 2, and because I love the Dark Souls series, that's just an awesome thing that kind of invokes that image. And how, like, especially it relates to Shilva Sanctum because it's got the skulk, which collapsed the ancient civilization, kind of how, like, the poison collapsed the ancient civilization in Dark Souls. It's just so interesting. Like, there's so many lore potential, and it just looks very fun to explore. And they're also talking about adding unique loot, so there could be potentially some game-changing enchantments, tools, or items coming our way, and that's just exciting to think about. And then the Warden, like, he's even scarier than he was before. The shriek blocks and the darkness. Like, I don't even know how to, like, process it all. It's just very cool, and it just does seem worth the wait. Overall, like I said, I cannot wait. I just honestly wish I had more time to play Minecraft with the busy adult life. Like, Halloween's coming up. I really want to make a Halloween special episode from the server. But do I have time to do that? We'll see. But when it comes to 1.19, let me know what feature is your favorite. And be sure to subscribe, as I love playing survival and build a lot on the BobSMP server. So I will see you guys around.